Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome back to Let's Play Banjo Kazooie. With me, TapersCrazy. Well, let's lift off. We made our start on Rusty Bookie Bay, and today I'm hopefully going to get Rusty Bookie Bay finished. But we'll see how well that one goes. Because Rusty Bookie Bay is like one of the more notorious levels. Okay, so it can't get me if I go through that hole, so let's go back around and get back to the ladder. So yeah, this is like one of the more notorious levels. There's a certain puzzle which I think everyone knows about revolving around a engine, which causes a lot of problems. So since I didn't do that first, I'm probably gonna have to do it last. It's a first or last kind of thing, I guess. Got the camera around here just like switching for some reason. Oh well. Okay, so now for everything around here, we can avoid going to Snackers' little thing that he's got going on there. Got all these things. Okay, do I have everything from here? I do. Just don't fall in, because Snackers is a very unforgiving shark. And a very hungry one all the time, apparently, given how much he's like... I mean, can you imagine a shark trying to eat a bear in your life? That'd be ridiculous. Okay, perfect. And we shall go up here. Okay, so they need to go in there, because that's where the... Jinzo was. Was it the Jinzo? No, it was the honeycomb piece. Okay. Well, this looks kind of lethal, so I don't want anything to do with what's going on in here. Okay, well, that didn't look safe. Get out of toxic sludge, Banjo. Oh my god, is this? How do I get out? Oh, stairs. Okay. Jesus. Well, that was... Why am I, like, making these silly rookie mistakes? It's insane. Oh, well. Oh, I took a bit of damage, but that's to be expected. Can I... This looks suspicious to me. No, I guess I'm reading too much into it. Okay, so we've got whatever was over there. Was it a Jinzo? I don't know. It was something over there that I got, so... Oh, what was that? It's just stairs over here. Oh, well. By stairs, I mean ladder, of course. There you go. Let's wait for that guy to blow up. What's up? Oh, no, it's around back here before I go up that jump pad. Oh, might as well get all the tolls out of the way. No, wrong one. I was about to say, like, why is it not counting the last one, but then it did. It just seems to take a long amount of time. Okay. I want to know what's up with that crane, though. Big yellow thing. We'll find out eventually, I'm sure. Ooh, more crates. I've been in these, haven't I, though, so... Yes, I have. Okay. Oh, so do I need to get on the crane to get to the other side, question mark? I assume I do, guys. So it's like one of those things where, like... Similar to Pokemon Yellow, where pretty much every person that's ever LP'd the game, including this one, like, they just seem to know where they're going and what they're doing, but, like, I don't, like, because, like, you can go around and, like, research where to go in the game and stuff, but where's the fun in that, man? I do that if I get really, really stuck, so... Anything up here? No, there's no hidden things. What does this do? Oh. Wait, so I've got 16 seconds to get over there. How the frick am I supposed to do that in time? Okay, I believe I can do it. No, Banjo, get up! Get up, Banjo! Well, at least I got the jiggy, I guess. But how do I get back over there? Yes, it's a filter. I was actually kind of lucky that that wasn't one of those, what do you call them? One of those, living pipes. You know those pipes that try and kill you? Okay, what about that one? Okay, let's get back up on the crane and see what's up there. I mean, I risk everything to go and get that bloody jiggy piece. I like, risked all my health as well. Which is not a good thing, so like we all know with me, health is so hard to come by. Well, I don't need to worry about that again. I just don't think I collected everything on my way up here because I was in a rush, so... Might as well look around. I've got a golden feather. I've got all the golden feathers. I want to know how to get over there, though. Do I need to climb up that box? Probably. Okay, well, let's go... onto the boat. Okay, so what's this then? I assume there's a boat. I think there's a boat number on the side of a boat, which is supposed to be what number you're supposed to put in there. So, oh come on, that's a bit trolly that you can't get up there. Oh well, that's kind of decent actually. The box is down there, so I don't want to go in that pipe just yet. I want to see if there's a number on the side of the boat. Probably on the other side, to be honest, but. No harm in having a look around, right? Okay. Just as long as I can get around the boat, like, I'm just, this is all me just acclimatizing myself to the actual boat and getting around everything. Okay, maybe the number is on this side. See, I don't know where it is. I think it starts with a 3. No, it's not. Oh, is it down here? No. I don't know, we'll find it eventually, I'm sure. Excuse me, living life preserver that's oddly enough trying to kill me, along with everything else in this bloody game. Yeah. I assume I can get through there. Thought as much. But I want to get everything that's like off the boat first. Well, like, on the outside, not necessarily on the inside. Okay, so that is actually how you get up here. You're supposed to climb up this thing. Okay, there we go, we're on here. And do I risk jumping down, or do I just like... Can I actually grab hold of a ladder? I can, okay, perfect. I don't want to risk losing the little health that I've got by jumping down here, so... And I think this is probably going to be a bit more simplistic than the... than the other one, because I get the feeling that this is not going to be time because it's just going to drop the T-box. Don't hit it. Smash it. Yes, it's going to drop a huge explosive and cause a lot of damage, I assume. Hope no one was under that. I mean, it's kind of weird, like, virtually. Like, remember back in... Because it was, like, this idea that I had when I was little, like... When I was playing games which didn't have like any people in them, like any NPCs, I imagine that there was actually NPCs there. In the same look, like that's like when you're playing games like Grand Theft Auto and you pretend to be a normal person, you sort of like behave in a way where the game... There's gotta be something over here. Question mark? Or else why would we need to do this? Or is this supposed to be just some sort of health farm? In which case, I don't mind because I could do with the health. I heard a Jinzo. Yeah. Okay, so that's what this is for. Okay, but what's over there? You've got the crates over there, but I don't think they mean anything. I guess. Okay, so let's get back on the boat and get those... Oh shit, I forgot that this other platform worked. Okay, fair enough. Okay, so let's go back to the start anyway. Because I can get back onto the boat anyway. So I'll work my way around. I'll come back to you when I'm on the boat again. Okay, I'm back at the start of a level. I just got back on here, so I want to go this way actually and see what's over here. There is an explosive, which kind of looks aggressive, but I don't think we need to be worrying about him right now. But it looks like there's a way down there. Oh, there is actually a Jinzo down there. Why do we get the feeling then that I've got a there's going to be an opening somewhere that I can use down here? Is there? There is! Okay, so let's make this quick then. Given the fact that I can't really breathe underwater around here. Oh shit, I've got other Jinzos as well. Okay, quickly. No, I'm gonna have to come back for it. This is too risky. Okay, and when I surface, my health doesn't regenerate. Quick. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm gonna have to go back for that jiggy, so I'll go back to you when I get it. Okay, I got the jiggy piece, so let's get out and dodge. But I do get a feeling there's more in that place, though. I don't know, I can look at it through the grate, it's fine. Oh, you were supposed to smash this window. See, I thought there was something fishy about it. So, anyway, we're in here now, so I guess I might as well have a good old mosey on around and make sure we can get everything that's actually in here. Okay, oh god, I'm glad there wasn't a hole there. That would have been awkward. Jesus, man. I knew there was something off about that window. I'm like, why is it not yellow like all the other ones? So, I was right and everyone else was wrong. Well, you was probably all right as well, but... we're alright and everyone else was wrong, guys. Get out of here, man. Thinking you can just eat anyone that walks on by. In fact, that is actually really clever. I love how like a lot of the times I just hide things in the worlds. Like, they sort of like hide like really important things in certain areas. It's sort of like rewarding to collect the items. God damn it, man. Oh, come on, Banjo, man. You didn't need to fall that far. It's like you got freaking Fuss Road Dad out of this damn place. Okay, well, now is the time to panic, given that I can't get out of the water. Okay, perfect. Oh, Jesus, man. Get out of town. Okay, so where do I need to go now? Is it over here? It's got to be in here somewhere. I've not got to go out, have I? Because I got knocked off like an idiot. Okay, then. I'll cut back to you when I get back in here, then. Oh, you could just jump across the boxes. Okay, that's fair enough, then. Get out of here, man. Look at him thinking he's all clever, like, yeah, I'm going to jump out and eat him. Not if I'm doing a rat attack, you know, you bastard. Okay, I'm kind of concerned, because I've got... what is it? Oh, no, actually, 4 jiggies to... 50-odd notes. I think that's probably a decent tally, actually. Okay, is that everything? I think that's everything. Yeah, we use a jump back. Yeah, that's everything in here other than those eggs, so... I think that's a job well done. So that's alleviated my concerns that I've got everything that's outside. Oh, I could have come through here. Okay, so let's get back to the start where the... ladder is to the start of. Well, can you please cooperate with me, camera? Okay, perfect. And I need to go find the number of a boat, so I'll come back to you in a second, guys. Oh, it's here, look. It's 312111, so I'm going to go punch that into the whistles at the front of a boat. Don't you dare knock me off this boy, asshole. I will slap a bitch. And you are the bitch that I will be slapping, so 312111. Pretty easy number. It's kind of lenient that they've put 3 ones at the end, so... alright, unless there's another number around, which is not as lenient as that, cause like... 312111, I assume that's like... a reference to some kind of date. But anyway, let's just punch that number in, like... pretty simple. You think it'd be something to do with the tolls around the... if it'd be something to do with the tolls that are around the actual harbour, but no. Okay. Any good? Hey! Well, it couldn't have ended with a 2, because then otherwise you would have picked up a jiggy straight away, so... it had to be a 3 or a 1 that it ended with. Just simple programming, okay. So let's see what else we can do. I want to go up onto this chimney. See what's up here. I'd assume that at some point there'd be... no, there's no more Jinzos to collect, because I've... well, save, collect them. It makes me think like I've just got like 50 Jinzos, like, on a shelf in Banjo's home. Could happen, it could happen. I don't know what Banjo does with the Jinzos. Nor does anyone else. They're supposed to be saving them. I see the jump pad there, but I want to get all of these. I assume there's going to be a jiggy at the top of all this. Given that it's making me go all this way around the damn thing. Oh yeah, there you go. Thought as much. Since it was like just like this huge platforming section, I was like, there's got to be a jiggy up here. Let's see what's on that jump pad though. Just control yourself when you're flying. Dangerous thing. What on earth was that? Just complacency on my part. I'll come back to you and get back up there. Okay, I'm back up here and I've dealt with that arsehole. So let's jump up here and see what is actually up here. A Mumbo token. I lost most of my health for a bloody Mumbo token. Story of my life. Okay, so the next thing I've got to do, I guess, is... I saw there was a place which I knocked through at the bottom of this chimney. So let's see what's in here. Like, there's definitely one bit that I want to avoid doing for now. Ooh! God, every time, man. See, I keep mocking them, saying, "Oh, you're not clever, yeah, yeah, yeah." And then you're nearly getting killed by them all the time, so... Okay, is this all that's in here, just this? Okay. There's a thing there. You see. Good job, I saw that, actually. So that's both honeycomb pieces of this world. Okay, is this the place that I want to be at? Okay, I thought you was gonna change, actually. Okay, so can I get up here? I'm not sure if I can. I'm not sure if I want to. Screw it, let's take a dig. No, Banjo! Bollocks. Nothing I could have done. I was just prolonging the inevitable at that point. God damn it. Okay, I made it up here, but like, there's moving things around here, so... I think I need to hold off, like... But I definitely think this is the bit that I was speaking about, which is like the really hard part, but... Yeah, just play it safe. Is there any way that I can switch all this off? This is insane. Okay. Come on. There's gotta be a way where I can switch all this off, because this is just absolutely insane. It's like... Okay, what does that do? Well, it slows the fans down, I guess. Okay, but like, does the timer for this activate? I get a feeling I've missed a trick here. Maybe. Fox is real. I get a feeling I've missed a trick in here because it seems like a lot of this stuff shouldn't be moving. Okay, let's get these notes that were just here, which I seem to neglect. You gotta be kidding me with this jump, right? That's maddeningly insane. Okay, before I hit that switch though, I wanna go up here and get... What is going on here? See, I had a feeling that I was supposed to press that in there before I came in here. I guess it would have made life a lot easier, but it's fine. Okay. So let's press this switch and see what happens. It turns the engines off. But for 65 seconds. Oh, Jesus. Okay, I think we can do this. I think we should be okay to do this. Oh, does it turn these off as well? Perfect. Let's turn these off. Don't switch. Don't switch. Don't switch. It didn't switch. Okay. Come on. Come on, Banjo. We can do this. I believe in you. Believe in the cause, Banjo. Believe in the cause. God, it took so long to get up here. Where's the door? Where's the door? Where's the door? Where's the door? It's here. Okay, and now I need to get to the back of a boat. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Don't have time. 20 seconds. Will we do this? Will we do this? We will. We've got to. We've got to do this. Come on. Come on. Banjo, get stuck in. And then get out again. Banjo, get out! Get out, Banjo! Get out! Get out! I'm out! I did it! Yes! Get the turn back on again. I did it! I did it, man! I mean, the main difficulty of that was, like, doing the whole platforming bit around, but, like, I want to know if that switched us in, like, the other room. But anyway, just going to get back to the start of the level. Because I'm out of time this one, so next episode I'll cut back to you at the start of the level, and then we shall get the rest of the jiggies and the notes. So, yeah, I've not that much more to do, so. Thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.